One thing that almost every YouTube creator would like to have is more subscribers. We can't all be like Casey Neistat and get a new subscriber every 1 or 2 seconds. So I'd like to show you how to use the Canva website to help you create a clickable subscribe button that'll show up on all your YouTube videos. Go to the Canva website and create a free account if you don't already have one. Canva does have a paid option that'll give you more features, but the free account will work just fine for us. When you've logged in, you'll see a page similar to this and a section that says create a design. And there's some preset, pre-made design templates there for different purposes. But we want to go and click on use custom dimensions and put in 800 by 800 pixels and click design. And then we get our workspace right there. And there are several choices here. These are Canva layouts that are already pre-made. Click there and there are elements, different shapes. There's text that you can add, different fonts. There are different colored solid backgrounds and textured backgrounds, and this is a section where you can upload your own images. But we're going to go to background first, and I want something that's kind of a YouTube red. There's all kinds of colors you can use. But there's a red. I really want one darker, so you can click there. And there's a color wheel, and you can drag the little dot to wherever you want to on that color wheel and pick a color. I'm going to pull it further into the red and have a little darker red going on. It also gives you the color code for the color you've created. You can write that down in case you want to use it for another project. If you have a paid account, it stores that for you. And now let's go to elements and then shapes, and I want a white square to put on my red background. These say free. A paid account has more options. And there's our white square. And you can move it around and it'll tell you when it's centered vertically and horizontally. There, it's just right in the center, vertically and horizontally. So I'm going to move it up a little bit vertically and pull it up, shorten the box so there's room below for text. And then now I want a triangle, something that I can use to simulate a play button. So it puts it in there and it's white, so I don't want it white. So you can go up here and select a color. It has your basic options, but it also has the red that I just created. So we can click on that to get the same color of red. So there you go. And you can also click this button and it would change anything that's white to that red you just selected. I don't really want that, but that shows you what it can do. So then I want to pull this up a little higher, and then I want to trim it down, resize it a little bit, make it smaller. I'll center it there for now. And then I want to rotate it, have it point to the right to look more like a play button. Then I want to resize it again, make it smaller, and pull it down. There, it's kind of centered. I'm going to make it a little smaller so it'll stand out more. And now I'm going to select text to put some text underneath it. I want it to say subscribe. There's lots of different choices here, but I want something simple, something that'll stand out well and be very readable. So I'm going to go down to the example that has the word dazzle and select it. And that'll place the text box over in the work area. And it tells you at the top of the work area there that the font name is Glacial Indifference. And you can resize this box. I want it to eventually end up being the full width of that area at the bottom. It comes with pre-filled text, and you'll want to delete that Eau de Parfum, or however you say it. And then we'll pull this out some more to get it edge to edge. And delete the dazzle text, and I want to put in subscribe. So we've got that. There's the Glacial Indifference font indication, and that is the size of the font. Not big enough, so I'm going to try 88. A little too big. I'm going to go back and hit 80, and that's pretty good. I might try a little bigger. I'm going to try 85, so you can actually go up and type that in there, whatever font size you want, and hit enter, and it pulled it across a little more, so I'll leave it there. And then get it centered again horizontally and vertically in that lower section. And there you have your basic subscribe button. You can save it, although it automatically saves pretty often. And then you want to download it to whatever folder you've got set up for this. PNG is the default recommended file format here for saving, and it's one that YouTube also recommends. And so we're going to save it there. There are other things that you can create besides just a subscribe button that'll serve the same purpose. You can upload your own image. This is a graphic I use on one of my channels. I'm going to pull that out and fill that workspace, that 800 by 800 size, and save that. You can also upload a picture of yourself, or in this case, me, although I decided I didn't want my face staring back at everybody on all my videos. Or if your channel is all about cars, you could upload a graphic of a vehicle, and that would make a great watermark. So what do you do with what you've just created? Well, go to your channel, be sure you're in Creator Studio, and then go to the left-hand column and select Channel. And under Channel, select Branding. And under Branding, there's a button that says Add a Watermark. Click that. And it gives you some guidelines about the recommended file format. That's either PNG or GIF, although you can use JPEG. And the maximum file size is 1 megabyte. And then choose File and go to where you save that and select your subscribe button. And then hit Save. And then it shows you your uploaded watermark. So hit Save again. Then it shows you your watermark here and it says showing on all your uploads. And over here you can choose when it displays. You can choose for it to show at the end of the video, choose a custom start time, or have it show for the entire video. I'm going to choose custom start time and have it start showing 10 seconds into each video. And click Update. So let's take a look at a video and see how that subscribe button looks. There it is in the lower right hand corner. And if they do click on that image, it takes them right to your channel. They can see what you're all about, and if they want to, they can subscribe. It's a great benefit having this watermark on all your videos. I know it helped my channel after I added it to all my videos, and I really believe it can help you too. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe to my channel if you would, and have a great day. Bye.